Did you know that one of the world's most infectious viruses can survive in your body fluids for up to 7 days, even in saliva, sweat, and tears? Did you know that the hepatitis B virus can survive outside the body for up to 7 days? While many people know it spreads through blood, the truth is far more surprising. In fact, it can survive outside the body for days, raising concerns about other possible ways it could be transmitted. So, what does this mean for everyday life? While the primary mode of hepatitis B virus transmission is through blood, it can also be found in other bodily fluids. However, before you panic, the risk of transmission through fluids like saliva, sweat, and tears is quite different from blood, semen, or vaginal fluids. Let's take a closer look at how the virus behaves in each of these fluids and why some pose more risk than others. For instance, you might be wondering if something as common as saliva could be a real threat. Yes, hepatitis B virus can exist in saliva, but the concentration is much lower than in blood. This means that the chance of getting infected through saliva is pretty low, unless there's blood involved. For example, if both an infected and uninfected person have open sores in their mouths, the virus could be transmitted through something as simple as a kiss. Additionally, it's possible to transmit the virus through biting if it involves blood, which is more common in settings like childcare or among siblings in regions where hepatitis B is widespread. Despite these possibilities, there's no need to worry about catching hepatitis B virus from sharing utensils or food. The virus is not spread through casual contact like that unless blood is exchanged, so sharing a meal or drink with someone won't put you at risk. Furthermore, when we look at sweat, the situation becomes even less concerning. You might have heard that some studies detected HBV in sweat, but don't be alarmed, there's no evidence that sweat can transmit the virus. The virus doesn't exist in sweat at levels that would be dangerous, which means activities like working out, playing sports, or casual physical contact are safe. Therefore, you can hit the gym or play that game of basketball without worrying about hepatitis B. Similarly, tears also don't pose much of a threat. Much like sweat, tears can contain traces of HBV, but the amount present is so tiny that it poses no risk. Even if you wipe someone's tears away or cry near them, you don't need to fear catching the virus. There's simply no documented case of HBV being spread through tears. Adding to this, HBV can be found in urine, but just like sweat and tears, the concentration is too low to cause concern. No known cases of transmission through urine have been reported. Therefore, activities like changing diapers or caring for someone who needs help with toileting are considered safe, as there is no real risk of HBV spreading in these situations. In a different scenario, breast milk comes into the picture as another bodily fluid where HBV might exist. It might surprise you that HBV can be found in breast milk, but the likelihood of a baby catching the virus through breastfeeding is very low. Infants born to HBV-infected mothers receive immediate protection in the form of vaccines and hepatitis B immune globulin, HBIG, right after birth, significantly reducing their risk. The World Health Organization, WHO, even recommends that mothers with hepatitis B can safely breastfeed their babies, as long as the infant is properly vaccinated. Note that there is more to be done when preventing mother-to-child transmission of hepatitis B. Kindly see your doctors for a comprehensive care. Although the risk of transmission through saliva, sweat, tears, urine, and breast milk is low, the main ways HBV spreads are through blood and sexual contact. It is primarily transmitted through contact with infected blood or bodily fluids in more direct ways. One of the most widespread methods of transmission occurs during childbirth, where infected mothers can pass the virus to their babies. Thankfully, with early vaccination, this risk can be dramatically reduced. Moreover, sharing needles during drug use or certain medical procedures is one of the most effective ways for HBV to spread. In fact, unsafe practices in settings like tattoo parlors, where sterilization might be poor, can also increase the risk. However, in developed countries, blood donations are rigorously screened, making transmission through blood transfusions extremely rare. In addition to these blood-related transmissions, HBV is also classified as a sexually transmitted infection, STI, and it can be spread through unprotected sexual contact with an infected partner. Whether heterosexual or homosexual, the virus can be transmitted, especially if there are cuts, abrasions, or sores involved. Watch our next video on how to protect your loved ones from hepatitis B. For more information on hepatitis B cure research, treatment, and prevention, kindly subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell.